Dogs on BCTV is supported by the Berks County Kennel Club and by the Berks County Dog Training Club.
Good evening and welcome to the Berks County Dog Training Club's program, All About Dogs. Hi, I'm Pat Mock, your host. And this evening, we're going to be talking about two performance events that the AKC does. The one is the Canine Good Citizenship Test, CGC for short, and the other is the Trick Dog Titles. Now, this is something that all dogs can do. As you can see, Odin is a mixed breed crossbred dog. He's not purebred. So any dog can do this, even though it's run by the American Kennel Club. You can still do any kind of a mixed breed dog that is not a purebred. They can get all these titles as well. In fact, they're allowed to get any of the performance event titles. So, you know, it's something to do with your dog and it's fun. So my guests this evening are Steffi Mays, who is to my immediate left, and Chrissy Schaeffer and her dog, Odin. So first of all, let's talk about the CGC. This is the Canine Good Citizenship Test. Well, what does that mean?
Well, it means that you're taking a little bit of extra time to make sure that your dog is a good member of the community, mm-hmm. is stable mm-hmm. and confident, and that you've taken that extra time to put in to make sure that he acts accordingly.
Okay. Well, I know at one point, too, and maybe it still is that way, you know, a lot of the insurance companies were using the CGC as a verification that the dog was not aggressive. So that, you know, if you were buying a house, mortgaging a house, and you wanted to get insurance, and you had, you know, a vicious dog, a Rottweiler, a Weimaraner, the list is just, I mean, that's really dumb. But anyhow, if you had a CGC title from the American Kennel Club, they would give you insurance with no problems. So in that way, it's really helpful for people who have dogs that are quote unquote, you know, aggressive dogs. But anyhow, any dog can be aggressive. I mean, you know, I've been bitten by more little dogs than I have ever been by a big one. Anyhow, so this is, what do you do for the CGC test? Now, these are classes that the Berks County Dog Training Club does hold. And these are two of the instructors, and they both did this with their dogs as well. So, you know, they know what they're talking about. So what are some of the test things that you do for the dogs?
Okay, well, first of all, any dog can be tested.
Mm-hmm.
Hopefully they have the skills to be tested, but we can't deny testing any dog that comes.
Right.
It's recommended probably 6 months at least.
Yes.
Hopefully they've had some training under their belts. Is helpful in the basic skills.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
There are 10 items that they have to pass, all 10.
Okay.
Would you like us to show you the 10 items? Or
Why don't you tell us what they are first,
and then
we'll
go
through. Right, and then we'll demonstrate them.
Well, the first one is, there's 10 items, they must pass all 10 items. The first one is accepts a friendly stranger.
Okay.
The second one is sits politely for petting. And then we have being able to be groomed and ears and feet being touched, which is hard for a lot of dogs.
Yes, it is. Mm-hmm. They don't like their feet touched.
The next one is out for a walk, which means they have to just do a walking pattern to show mm-hmm. that the owner has control of the dog,
right.
The handler has control of the dog.
Right, and this is where your training comes in.
Exactly. Well, and even some more, it really comes in all for all of them.
Okay.
Walking through a crowd,
uh-huh.
Which just consists of three people.
Uh-huh.
And
mm-hmm.
Then there's a sit, a down, and a stay, and a recall.
Okay.
Recall means that you call the dog, and the dog
mm-hmm.
wants to come
mm-hmm.
to you willingly.
Right.
A reaction to another dog that they can sort of meet and greet, and reaction to distractions. And finally, I think it's the hardest one, but it's a separation of a 3-minute separation where the owner has to go out of sight, and someone, hopefully sort of friendly, holds your and knows what they're doing, holds
yes,
the dog
yes.
while you go out of sight.
Yes. Okay.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So you want to demonstrate these tests with Odin?
Yes. And first of all, can I tell you, the reason we hold the classes is we want to get people prepared for the test. A lot of places where you go and give the basic skills, they have certain collars and things that they have to wear. But we can only do certain collars. One of the collars that they can wear is what Odin has on. It's a flat buckle collar.
Okay. Well, he has on a martingale.
He has the martingale. It looks like a flat buckle without that. Or martingale collar.
Mm-hmm.
Or a slip collar, which is your common choke collar. They can also have a harness.
Okay.
A body harness.
Mm-hmm.
But they cannot have a head halter or retractable leashes.
Okay.
The leashes have to be either just leather or fabric leashes.
Well, what about prongs?
No shock collars, no prongs. I just wanted to get that out there. Sometimes the dogs need a little extra practice getting used to behaving maybe when they don't have those kind of collars.
And especially since you're doing this in a class environment, you know, your dog may be perfect at home. We all have that. Oh, yeah, my dog is so great at home. And then you get him out someplace and he's a wild idiot. But that's where you're training in a class environment. So all of these people are being tested at the same time. What do you take? Six people, eight people?
Well, each of us has about six
when
we teach the class. But they are tested individually.
Yes, yes. Mm-hmm. Right. Yeah, well, you would have to.
Yes.
Okay, so why don't we show the first one, which is
accepting a friendly stranger. And
what,
this is just
ready? I put this down on the cord.
Oh, well, that's not a good idea.
So it's just that I can walk up, and we can just sort of say hello, and the dog's not going to jump all over me.
Stay.
We're looking for control. The dog can show interest, but he can't obviously jump on top of me. Hi, how are you?
Good, how are you?
Nice to see you.
Nice to see you, too. Howdy. Sit.
Okay.
Oh, that was good.
Mm-hmm. Then they can say hello to you too.
Right.
Just gently. Yeah.
They don't have to sit and stay.
They can show a little bit of interest, but it's just that they can't be all over.
But they can't jump, which is probably hard for some breeds, especially the little dogs are like labs.
And Odin knows me very well, it's going to be harder for him to meet me because I'm not really a stranger to Odin.
Right.
Odin.
All right, come on. The next one is sits politely for petting. And again, it's just control that they're not going to jump all over you, that you can pet them.
Stay.
And they're not going to bite you.
Stay.
That's the big part.
Because there are sometimes we worry. Some dogs don't know somebody, and they are a little afraid.
Right.
So we want to make sure that the dog is okay with strangers.
Stay.
But may I pet your dog?
Yes, you may.
But if you're out in public, you know, you got to be aware that the dog is friendly, you know, not that it's going to jump and attack somebody.
Hopefully.
Right. That's exactly right.
And that's what you want to just proof those things.
Right, right.
During the test, you can't use treats.
Okay.
After they do each one of the items, then they can go back and be rewarded. But they can't have give treats to lure the dog into a sit or lure the dog to stay.
Yeah.
They have to be without the treats. Okay, the third one is one of the ones I think they say is one of the hardest for the dogs to pass. Because a lot of dogs don't like their paws and their ears looked at. And most of these tests have a reason behind them. This one is, will your dog be able to go nicely to the vet, have the vet examine them, look in their ears, pick up their paws, and go into the groomers if you can groom the dog nicely.
Sit.
So we want to make sure that the dog's going to be comfortable with all of that.
Okay.
May I look in your ears, Odin?
Yes, you may.
Okay.
Good. Very nice. They're just going to just take a little peek. And, you know, they have to have their feet, paws, nails need to be trimmed. So you need to be comfortable with their paws being touched by someone else. And the owner can pick up the paw if they feel comfortable like that.
Great job, Odin. Good boy.
Yay.
So that's all that involves. It's not, it looks easy because Odin's very used to it, but for a lot of dogs, that is not an easy task to
and
have.
And especially if you haven't been trimming your dog's nails.
Yep.
Which is, you
know. Well, and even just to have a stranger do it too, because some dogs just aren't as trustful.
Right.
So we have to make sure that they're doing that.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Good boy.
Out for a walk. Again, this is a simulated pattern. We're going to have him do a left turn, a right turn, two stops and an about turn.
Okay.
Just to show that Chrissy has control over Odin, that he's not going to take her for a walk.
Yes.
She's going to take him for a walk.
You ready?
All right. Forward.
Odin, heel.
Left turn.
Back. Good boy.
A little close in here. About turn.
Come on. Let's go. Yay.
Oh.
Sit. Forward.
On here.
Right turn.
Let's go.
And halt.
Sit.
And they don't have to sit. The dogs do not have to sit. Odin's had lots of obedience. They can just, if you stop, as long as the dog stands still and is controlled and standing nicely with you, that's
Yay.
And then walking through the crowd is pretty much similar. Sometimes we have walkers or somebody maybe holding an umbrella. And again, they can walk as long as they walk nicely through the crowds.
Right.
But aren't, again, jumping all over one, out of control, pulling the owner. So, and not too distracted by the distractions that we give them.
Yeah.
Okay.
How about if we do the sit, the down, and the come?
Okay.
All right.
Where would you like me?
Right there is good.
Yeah. Okay.
Okay. And I'm going to sit right down.
Sit.
All right. Okay. Chrissy, just walk in a little circle with him to get him up.
Okay.
Okay.
Come
on. Walk in a little circle.
And, come on.
And I'm going to say...
Back.
Show me that your dog can sit. Show me that your dog can sit. Okay, and show me that your dog can go down.
Down.
Very nice. We can't have any lures in our hands or anything like that. Yeah. They just have to be able to do it. And then I'm going to ask for a stay, which means she's going to have to walk. And this is hard because a lot of people go stay with, and they walk facing their dogs, and they walk backwards. Chrissy's going to walk out forward. And then she's going to have to turn around and come back. So having your back to the dog and having him stay is a little tougher.
Yes.
Okay. Tell your dog to stay.
Stay.
Leave him.
How far do you have to go?
For this one, it's 20 feet. Great job.
Now, does he have to stay down until she gets back to his side?
They can move as long as they stay in that place.
Okay. Okay.
In that position. How do I say, as intense as obedience like your CGC, we can talk to, we encourage, in fact, that you talk to your dogs the whole time, encourage them with your voice, with your, you know, clapping of hands. They do not have to be as strictly controlled.
Yes.
Just like to be kind of in a, just an everyday setting.
Right.
You would talk
to
your dog normally.
John Q. Public taking his dog out.
Exactly right.
In a situation, well, like tonight, they have National Night Out here on Penn Street. And if you decided to walk your dog up, you know, they're going to have to be friendly. They're going to have to walk with you. Obviously, you're going to stop. So the dog has to sit and not continue walking on while you're stopping at one of the stands to, you know, talk to people.
Exactly.
And, you know, they can't jump up on the table things like that. Yeah.
Yeah. Just showing that they're polite.
Right. Right.
And polite through sound.
That they are a good citizen.
Yep. And Chrissy, let's do a recall. And recalls, we say, are just so important to teach your dog.
Yes, yes.
It can be life-saving.
Oh, you better believe
it. If they have a good recall. So we always tell our people, whenever you do a recall, make your voice be happy. And always call your dog for something positive.
Right.
Never for anything negative, because otherwise you're going to send them cross signals.
Right, right.
They won't know when it's okay to come and when it's not okay to come. You always want them to be willing to come to you, whether it's for a treat or just some great petting.
Or a toy.
Play. Just so they know it's going to be something wonderful.
Right.
This one, you only have to go out 10 feet.
Okay.
And you can clap your hands to call your dog. You can get down and call them that way.
Okay.
It's not formal like the regular obedience.
Yeah,
it's just, will your dog come to you when you call them? Okay, Chrissy, leave Odin. And call Odin.
Odin, front!
Did the floor move?
Odin's had a tough day. He's done agility today and scent work.
And it's even air conditioning here, Odin.
And they do not have to do a formal sit in front.
Okay.
As long as they come to their person, are willing to come to their person.
Right.
Odin, come
here. A reaction to another dog would just be very similar to where it was meeting a friendly stranger.
Okay.
Only the friendly stranger would also have a dog, and the dog's would be
on the offside.
Offsides of that.
Those dogs would be offside, So they would be on the left when you are greeting the person on the right.
Exactly.
With the right hand.
Yeah, they would both be on the left.
And it is at arm's length.
Yes.
It's not right on top of each other with the other dog. Your arm is out.
Yeah. We think about shaking hands.
Yeah.
Right.
So that each arm's out. So one dog's here, and one dog would be on the other side. So, and again, they can show a little bit of interest, but no pulling over.
Right. But if they have a good sit-stay, they shouldn't even, shouldn't bother them.
And you can tell your dog to sit and stay while you're doing that the whole time. You can tell them stay, and kind of say hello to the person.
Yeah.
Yes. And Chrissy, can you get the pan over there? The other one is a reaction to distractions.
Okay.
There's two types of distractions they have to show. I don't want to say no reaction to. Just like you, if somebody would come out and go, boo!
Yeah.
You would startle, and then you have to say, oh, it was no big deal.
Yes, yes,
so
yes.
So they can show a reaction, but they have to show that after they react
they
a little bit,
themselves.
They say, oh, it's no big deal. Okay, just not excessive barking or any kind of aggression or anything like that. Okay, so this is just a pie pan. There's two kinds. We do a visual. That would be maybe somebody riding a bike, pulling a cart, jogging in front of them. And then there's a sound, a noise one, which could be a pie plate falling about 5 feet in front. We don't want to scare these dogs unnecessarily. But just
especially
so that
if you're a rotten cook and you drop your pots along.
And it's just to simulate, you know, somebody might be walking, carrying a chair, and they may drop a, one of their, you know, lightweight chairs that they're taking to the ball game.
Right.
Again, the dog can startle. So I'm just going to walk and just kind of not, just, and it should be a little bit louder than that.
Yes, in fact, well, it's on carpeting.
We can, yes, this is on carpeting, but he showed absolutely no distractions, no signs of disturbance.
Yeah. He wanted to come and see if there was food in there.
Yeah, they could kind of investigate and see. And you know, actually, this probably did have a cake in not too long ago. I think I pulled a crumb out before I grabbed it on my way here tonight.
Come on, bud.
And the last one is being able to leave the room for 3 minutes. How about if I hold him, and can you just maybe go behind the camera person.
Oh, right. Not, right,
we won't do
curtain.
For, or out the curtain. We won't do for 3 minutes.
No.
Just for 30 seconds.
Okay. But we'll see how he does with this. It's been a while since he's done this.
Sit.
Odin, what I like to do is tell people to set them up.
Yes.
For a stay. Stay.
Yep. When I do mine, I usually just put her on a down stay because she's more comfortable. Odin, look. Hey, buddy. He's watching for his mom.
Yeah,
but as long as they aren't barking excessively or showing any
but they don't actually
signs
have
of
to
fear.
Continue
and this,
sitting, right?
This again is, no, they can get up and you can talk to them and pet them. And this is to show, you know, you might have to give it to a vet tech or your groomer to take. So all these, all of these have good reasons behind them and rationales behind them. This is just to say that he's maybe not real happy, but he's accepting that he's with somebody other than
like
his mom.
Or even like if you're walking with a friend and you need to go to the bathroom.
Exactly,
you know?
I was going to just say that. Right. If you have to go to the bathroom and you're someplace and you can say, could you, it's good.
Yeah, could you
hold
my dog?
You want to come back, Chrissy?
Yeah.
Would you hold my dog just so I go
Stay.
To do that? And they should, when they come back,
good
they have
boy.
To be calm. They, you don't want them jumping.
Good
so
boy.
We do practice that, coming back. And having your dog be calm when you come back and not lunging, come forward to come and meet you.
Right.
Yep.
You get a
cookie then there,
for that.
That's the last test.
That
there
would
other,
be the
there
last.
Are other things that, like the people have to sign, like an agreement that they're going to be a responsible dog owner?
Yes, we do have, we give it to them before class starts, and then at the end of class, it's on their report card. They do get a little report card. They either pass each item or needs a little bit more training.
Yes.
We try to be as positive as possible because we want people to want to train their dogs. And there are some that are so close to passing. And we just say, you know, just with a little bit more time and effort, you'll be great and your dog will be great. So
because I know one of the dogs that was in my class, he just couldn't resist jumping on people. He was so happy.
Yes.
You know, and you really felt bad for her because
that's a good thing, actually.
Yeah, she could not get the dog to keep four on the floor. I mean, he wasn't lunging at people. You know, he was just, you know, that kind of thing.
Exactly.
And, right.
And sometimes just a little maturity or a little bit more training on a specific thing. They can at the end, if they don't pass one class, one of the items, at the end they can take one item over.
Okay.
And redo. You get one redo.
To
pass it at the end of the class.
Mm-hmm.
There is an agreement. It's called the Responsible Dog Ownership, which I think is a wonderful agreement. I have it here. And it just says, I'll be responsible for my dog's health needs. And then there's several things, of course, taking your dog to the vet, make sure it has good fresh water and a proper diet all times and proper exercise. I will be responsible for my dog's safety, meaning that you'll make sure you'll have fencing when if you're at home, that they're not going to be able to get out, that they're going to be on appropriate leashes when you're walking. I will not allow my dog to infringe on the rights of others. I like this one because it talks about not excessive barking in the yard when they're mm-hmm. out. Also, I really emphasize, there's a couple of them, but I'll go over just a few of them. Making sure you have poop bags to clean up with
yep.
wherever you are to clean up after your dogs and keep mm-hmm. wherever you are nice and clean. And then I will be responsible for the quality of my dog's life. Of course, it's training that we know that that's an important part of dogs. We know that dogs that are trained and dogs that walk nice and on a leash are going to get to go a lot more mm-hmm. places
yes.
and have a better quality of life because they'll be able right, to be right. with their owners.
And the owners are more likely to keep them.
And yes, yes, that's another thing.
Right.
And they just said that owning a dog is time and commitment. And
yes,
that you understand this. So that's the responsible dog owner.
Mm-hmm.
I was here for the Star Puppy. We do the same responsible
mm-hmm.
ownership because
right.
they are important categories
right,
for the
right.
dogs.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we keep repeating it because it's very important. It is
yes.
very important. You know, you got a dog because you wanted a companion. Now, okay, you have it. Make it a companion.
Yep, exactly.
And that requires time and trouble
and
on your part.
And effort. Yeah,
that's
we
exactly
don't,
right.
They shouldn't be in a crate.
Right. Right, that's
you know,
exactly
24
right.
hours a day, they
that's
should be,
exactly with you.
Have a good quality
mm-hmm.
of life,
mm-hmm.
absolutely.
So then let's get into the trick dog a
yes.
little bit.
If you do the Canine Good Citizen, we offer the Canine Good Citizen and the trick dog together.
Okay.
Because you can get a trick dog if you pass 10 tricks with your dogs. There's three categories, novice, then intermediate, then advanced, and then, four categories, then performance dog.
Mm-hmm.
But with the Canine Good Citizen, you can get the novice trick dog. Usually it requires 10 of the tricks, but if you do the Canine Good Citizen, you only have to do 5 tricks.
Right.
So then we offer that, and we also offer it because if somebody doesn't necessarily get the Canine Good Citizenship award that night, they can still get an award
yes.
by performing the tricks.
Right.
The tricks.
Right. Mm-hmm.
So
right.
we like that everybody goes
yes.
home, hopefully a happy camper.
Yes. Yes.
Mm-hmm.
So
and
what are some of the tricks that you would have to do in like in the CGC? You know.
Yeah.
Those 5.
Okay.
Well, for the novice trick dog title, one of the fun tricks that they have to do is get in a box and sit in a box. That counts as 2 tricks. So, come on, get in the box. Come on. Yeah, good boy. Come on, come on.
It sit. Needs to be bigger.
Yay, good boy.
For a big dog like Odin, he
yep.
got in.
Yep.
Yeah, okay, free yep. time.
And some of them are just really good tricks, even like kenneling up, putting mm-hmm. your
come
dog
on.
In a kennel. Mm-hmm. That can count as a trick.
Sit.
Right, right.
Okay.
But,
Odin.
You know, getting in a box, you say it's an easy trick, but not for all dogs.
And, you know, that develops good body awareness.
That's exactly
for the dog
right.
and confidence for the dog.
Mm-hmm.
So, and, you know, when you do tricks, it's just fun. And the owners are happy when the dogs
right,
do
right,
tricks,
right.
too. And the dogs are happy. So it makes a nice breakup between the more structured things
uh-huh.
we're training
right,
to
right.
do and a little bit more fun.
Pause up. Yay, good boy.
And so you just have to get up on basically on something that would
yeah,
be
yeah,
step,
yeah, step up
step
on.
High.
Sit.
Mm-hmm.
Speak is one of them.
Speak is
speak.
One.
Good boy.
Good. Shaking paws. Some of them work well with what we're training.
Uh-huh.
So if we ask the dog to
yeah,
shake, we can certainly
good.
Look
right,
at their
right.
paws.
Oh, yeah,
mm-hmm.
that's exactly right.
So we
right.
try to work some of them in.
And that's a good one for owners whose dogs are mm-hmm. hard to touch their feet. Teach
yep,
them how to shake.
Exactly. And then, Chrissy, do a hand touch.
Touch.
And again, this is a trick
yeah.
where they just have
touch.
To touch. But it's a nice
touch.
Trick. It's the beginning
yeah.
of targeting. But also, it's a nice way if you have a shy dog and you ask somebody to put their hand out for the dog to touch
uh-huh.
before they pet them, it sort of breaks the ice
right,
for
right,
the dog.
Right,
so a
right.
lot of the tricks have an extra
yes, benefit.
Benefit
mm-hmm,
as well,
mm-hmm.
exactly.
Yeah, and most people, when they go to touch your dog, want to touch, excuse me, want to touch the dog on the top of the head.
Right.
And
can
then
you,
they quick jump back when the dog looks up to see
right.
this. And it just makes the box was in his way. You know, he had to kick it out of his way.
And that he's doing a pivot,
yeah,
so that's a more advanced trick.
Come here.
But you know, if I came into the room to put my hand over your head, don't you think you'd look up to see what the heck I was doing?
Exactly.
Here I am, a stranger, and
so
I'm putting my hand over your head. So if you would look up, why wouldn't you expect the dog to look up? And everybody goes, like that. And it's like, well, all he did was looked up. I mean,
exactly. Yeah. They, so, most dogs like to be petted more under their chin
or their side, their chin scratched.
Until that getting used to going over.
Plus, it's not an aggressive move on your part.
Right.
If you're coming at the dog like this, or at the dog like this to scratch under their chin. There are two, well, you obviously can see the difference between the two motions.
Yes.
That's aggressive on your part. This is not.
Yes.
So,
exactly.
You know, you have to think about what you're doing when you're going to pet a strange dog.
Yeah. Do you want to do a couple more tricks?
Sure.
Yeah. Okay.
Let's do some more tricks.
What else?
They're pretty easy. How about a spin?
A spin?
Mm-hmm.
All right.
This is just a fun
maybe
one.
Maybe you better move this.
Left, left.
Oh, we're good.
Left, left.
Good
boy. Bye, bye. Come on, right, right.
I know, I used the paws up. It came in handy when I was at the hospital the other day.
Uh-huh.
Somebody was in a very high bed.
Oh,
and I could do a paws up, and the person could see my dog's face. Yes, on a chair, when you're up on a chair.
Right. Uh-huh.
And there's another one where they get all four legs up on one, which is all
I won't ask him to do that on a chair.
I'm not sure that chair would manage to hold him.
How about some puppy push-ups? Again, we're asking them to sit and down. This is just kind of a fun way to do sit and down, so we can do that in with our...
Down.
Good.
Sit.
That's good.
Yeah.
And then hand signal for a sit. They can do a hand signal for a sit or down. It just is one hand signal, all they need. And we again, we try to work some of these in while we're teaching.
Yes.
While we're teaching the skills for the basic for the CGC. Yep.
But I mean, even like walking across a board, that's one
that
of the,
is just walking. And again, some of it's great for teaching your dog balance, body awareness, conditioning.
Yeah.
And just all those things build confidence in your dog.
That's,
and
that's
a confident dog is a good thing to have.
So then these classes are going to be held very soon.
Yes.
Okay.
Our next CGC course class, it's a little crazy, is going to be held on September 14th.
Okay.
It's a Wednesday night, and that's going to be from 6:30 to 7:30 at the Sinking Spring Fire Company.
And just go to the BerksDogTraining.com website, and you'll find out
and
all
you'll
this
find
information.
Out. And then the other
so
three.
So for this evening, we have to say goodbye.
Oh, okay.
So
well, look it up on
the
website.
Yes, so for this evening,
next
good night.
It's four classes. Okay, good night. We did great there.
With the time.
All About Dogs on BCTV is supported by the Berks County Kennel Club and by the Berks County Dog Training Club.